Howdy everyone. It is Friday, October 30th, 2020. I'm gonna be inking Gomez and Morticia Addams bats. We'll see what happens. I don't know that it translates that well into bats because it's not like they're wearing, they're just wearing. Well, I guess Gomez is wearing like a smoking robe, but just they're all in black. But I did I'm using a white bat for Morticia. That was a last minute decision because she's so white. Like, and she has all that black hair. I didn't know that it would translate. I think it will work a little bit better with Gomez, but it is Halloween Eve. I feel like this is gonna take me forever. I had to draw this three times because I did not like the way it was coming out. So I settled on this one. I guess with the bats I've done so far, they all have like something really distinctive, like big hair or something. A little more challenging. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Would like to watch another horror movie either tonight or maybe half tonight and half tomorrow. Who knows? Who knows? This shit takes a long time, and I still have to fix the ears for my costume. So I'll probably be inking for y'all tomorrow in costume. Fun times. There's an excellent chance I will not do anything else during the day. I feel like costumes are kind of, well, I guess if you're wearing a mask, it doesn't really make a difference, but I don't know, whatever. Sorry, my reference is sharing the screen. This is my laptop camera. So I gotta be looking at my screen. I can't do that if it's pointed down. I watched the Creepshow animated special yesterday. That was my horror viewing. It was alright. It was pretty good. I liked the first story, which was voiced by Kiefer Sutherland. That was pretty cool. It was pretty gross. It was pretty gruesome. I liked the story. It was fucked up, though. Not gonna lie. So if you don't know, it's an anthology show that has one season out on Shudder. So this the animated special got released yesterday. And so it's two stories. The whole episode was like 45 minutes long, so good 22 minutes each. The second story was all right. It was from a short story that I read not that long ago, so it was a little bit too fresh in my brain for me to really enjoy. I don't like to, I like to wait a while between like reading something and then watching the adaptation, just so like everything's not so predictable because I remember everything. Like, give it a few years to wear off. I made a Halloween mix of songs on the Spotifys. You know, I kind of feel like we don't even need Halloween mixes anymore because, like, John Carpenter makes albums, and don't know. There's a lot of music out there that just sounds like you're in a horror movie. This white bed is a little challenging because all of the little features kind of blend together. It's hard to tell when where something ends and the next thing begins. Like, the ears are almost translucent. Well, they're translucent though, so kind of just blend into the head. It's hard to see what distinguish the ear from the hair, the fur. And the ear's kind of at a weird angle, so gotta kind of figure it out for myself. Although I've drawn a good number of bat ears, so I can kind of fill in where I can't really see the anatomy accurately. I shouldn't even. It's so light, like the shadows don't even show up. I shouldn't even be putting shading on there. I am a little. I usually really love the fall. But like, now that we can't do shit indoors, I'm a little sad because it means I probably won't get to see anyone for a little while. Like, if I've, you know, I've had coffee with people outside. There are very few people that I've been indoors with. Socially, I mean. For work, I've had to, but that's like your masks are on the whole time. I just. Well, not that I didn't have them on outside, but. Like, if. My best friend, I want to go visit her. We take a walk. Can't do that. Might be a little fucked for a while. Get used to being alone again. It would be much easier if my parents would just let me get a cat. It's kind of hard to know how cartoony I want to go. If I make them too human, it's gonna look like weird furry shit. And I want them just to look like bats in clothing. I normally don't like some. I guess these flying foxes have cute little hands. Some of them it looks like they just have little hooks. But these little guys have hands. But they're tiny. So they're not exactly human. They're a little creepy, to be honest. I did ink these hands beforehand because there are a lot of digits intertwined, and I wanted to be very careful. And I know if I'm talking and trying to ink at the same time, I might fuck up. I don't have my. I'm unmedicated, so my focus isn't that great. Alright, that wasn't so bad. There you go, cutie pie. Looking like a little puppy, little sky pupper. It's the dumb shit like this that's gonna take me forever. Because I have to insist on doing every line. There's a store here in my neighborhood that I go look at action figures. I go there like maybe once a month. And I went today to look at. They get decent Halloween stuff sometimes. They have like cheap fishnets and things. Things that I will use beyond Halloween. So I went to go see what they had. I love that store. It's just called Toys and Variety. It's just a big blue sign that says Toys and Variety. And they do have a variety of things. I bought luggage there. Mostly I buy action figures. Marvel Legends, Marvel Universe. I think I bought an action figure there the first week stores opened up, retail stores, so that must have been in June. I was just so happy to buy something in the store that wasn't a necessity. I almost bought a black wig today. I was Morticia a few years ago. And I had one. It got fucked up when I moved though, so I threw it away. Actually, it was Mushy, my little orange boy. He. I had it hanging up on a hook, and he would basically like tear it off of the hook and bring it to me like he'd caught something, caught some prey, trying to gift it to me. So it was a little ratchet. It was not the healthiest looking wig. It was funny though. I would find it on my pillow. Like, oh, thank you, Mushy. It was very cute. So I almost bought one to replace that. But for what? And you can't be Morticia by herself. That's just depressing, Ingrid. I did see my favorite black cat twice today. I hope that means good luck for me. I love that cat. It's like a medium length furred black cat. And I've been seeing him for years. He survives every winter. People feed him around here, so. We have a lot of strays around here, though. There's like a little colony across the street of orange cats. But I never see the orange ones over here. I only see the black ones and a few tabbies. And a really pretty gray one. Gomez is gonna be a little more difficult. Let me bring up my reference there. for some reason this guy was kind of hard to draw. Like penciling stage. I'm not. We'll see how this little mouth comes out before I decide if I want to give him a mustache. I don't know that you'd even be able to tell us because he's all black. So it might be kind of pointless. You know what? We'll try. We'll try the mustache. We'll see how it works. Looks crazy. That's all right. It's a little bit funny, so I don't mind that he looks crazy. I finished my second book since quarantine started. I usually read a lot. I haven't been reading that much. Well, not just this year, but last year I didn't read that much either. More than now. A lot of my reading I did at the gym, so once that shut down, I was like, not gonna happen. So, I read Hunt for Skinwalker, which is a non-fiction book about a ranch in Utah known as, I forget what it's actually called, but they call it Skinwalker Ranch because they're skinwalkers, which are, I guess the way they describe them, the best way, they're like shapeshifters, but they often look like werewolves or wolves, some kind of dog creature. So that I read during the summer, the early summer. And Then I read the Beastie Boys book, which was a lot of fun. I liked it a lot. A lot of it reminded me of my own childhood, my teenage years growing up here in New York. I wonder if I would have been more normal or weirder if I grew up somewhere else. I did, you know, I have lived here since I was 15. Like, I was in New Jersey before that, from when I was 7 to 15. But I could not live like that again. Holy shit, was that boring. The highlight of my life was going to the fucking mall. No thanks, I'm good. This bat has very coarse hair. It's a little bit difficult to do with pen and ink. There's a lot of texture there. That's alright, it just takes a little longer. I have been watching Mr. Robot. That's why I haven't been watching that many horror movies. I love that show. I'm on the last season. Yeah, I gotta watch The Mandalorian too. I also got a lot of books this week. I got the last Ronin, the Ninja Turtles book. I have to read. I have to read the last issue of the Three Jokers. I have to reread issue 2 though. I don't know where the hell I put it. I got the new volume of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. That's always a priority. That's at the top of the reading pile. What else? I got the second issue of Heavy. I got the new Urasawa manga, Sneeze, which is a collection of short stories. It actually came out last week, but I had to wait. This mustache is ridiculous. Ridiculous. All the little phalanges, the little fingers here. It is New Music Day. I didn't listen to, you know, the Spotify new release radar. Haven't listened to that yet. I usually make that a priority on Fridays. What the fuck I was doing today that was so important. Spacing out. I've been having a shitty week, so. I shouldn't complain. I did not get a job that I wanted. But what can I do? I can't make anyone like me. I can't make anyone want to hire me. It's hard not to take it personally. It's rejection. Which I feel like I'm getting accustomed to. All right, my hand fell asleep. Since Inktober is almost done, I think I need to start working on pages again. But I need to scan like 80 pages. It's so fucking boring. Oh my god. I wish I had money so I could hire someone to do it. Because holy Jesus, I fucking hate scanning. I hate scanning, I hate lettering. Just let me draw. I just want to draw pictures. I don't mind the writing part. I guess I don't mind the lettering. I don't mind hand lettering. Digitally lettering is pretty awful. Doing anything digital is not my preference, because I'm a troglodyte, which is totally fine. Getting there. I hope good things happen in November. Or I'm gonna lose my shit. I shouldn't say that. But November is my time. Is that it? I think that's it. There we go. The cute couple. He's giving the kisses on the hand. It's adorable. Alright. Well, my friends, thank you for watching. I'll see you next Inktober video.